stop being greedy. Just keep it real, pot. Give to the needy. Ribs is touching, so don't make me wait. Fuck around and I'm gonna bite you. Snatch my plate.
SouthBoX Radio. Hard work, work.
My brother, Otto Wallin, what's poppin'?
Not much. I just woke up. How are you?
I'm blessed. You okay?
Yeah, everything's good.
So what I'm doing now is I'm getting my guy Max in here.
Yeah.
I'm getting my guy Max in here.
Nice.
And when I get Max in here, this one we're going to start joining. But this one we're going to get it popping.
Nice. How's everything with the gym?
The gym is amazing, Otto.
Nice.
The gym is amazing.
Yeah. That's great, man.
Great. You all right? You good?
Yeah.
What's up, gentlemen?
Hey, how are you?
My brother.
Pleasure to meet you, Otto.
You too.
Hey, thanks for being with us. My guy, my co-host, Max Forever.
Nice.
Pleasure to meet you, man.
You too. Yeah. Where are you, Otto?
Well, I'm in Florida right now. My family and I are spending the month down here, but normally I'd be right around where Eric is in New Jersey.
Okay. Nice.
Yeah. Have you been to the States much? I mean, aside from like the fights, just for, you know, being around the city?
Yeah. No, I live here now, so
I haven't been
back since. It's like pushing 1.5 years now because of the pandemic. So, but yeah, I like it there.
Very cool, man.
Yeah, thank you.
So, Otto Wallin, let's jump right into it.
Yeah.
You've been doing your thing, man. Like I said, I'm a big fan of yours. You're one of my favorite heavyweights today. I'm proud to have you on. And the heavyweight scope in boxing today is getting popping right now. You understand what I'm saying? You got yourself. You got, obviously, you got the champs, like Anthony Joshua, you got John Ruiz, Fury Wilder, you know, and you actually was in there with Tyson Fury.
Yeah.
So what was that? What was that experience like?
I mean, all in all, it was a great experience for me because, you know, as a young fighter that try to come up, you just want a big fight, right? So yes, I felt like finally I got a big fight, and it came pretty much out of nowhere. You know, he has got a call. They asked if I wanted to fight Fury. And so we jumped on it. And it came about. And we fought in Vegas. And I think for my career, it's been tremendous. You know, I put in a good performance. I wanted to win, of course. I didn't at the night, but I gave it my all. And I think that after the fight, my stock just went up. And, you know,
100%.
Yeah.
Fans live for fights like that, you know?
Yeah.
When a guy like you that didn't really have like the brand recognition yet comes in and does something big like that. I remember where I was when I was watching that fight. Did you surprise yourself? Like were you thinking everybody was underestimating you?
Everybody underestimated me. You know, People have never seen me fought at that time. So I understand that, you know, he fought a German guy before me that he wiped out in 2 rounds, and then they see me and they probably think I'm the same. So, you know, but I knew that I was good. I've been working very hard since I started boxing, you know, 15 years ago, something. And I was just happy to get the fight and to show everybody that I'm better than what they think.
Yes, sir. I'm going to say this, Otto. In that fight, you was able to catch Fury with a nice left hook. And that left hook opened up a deep gash on his eye. Personally, I think that if that cut was on your eye, they would have stopped the fight.
Yeah. Yeah, I mean, I would say that, I mean, this... not really any question about that. I'm sure they would have stopped it if it was for me. But, you know, that's how boxing works sometimes. He was the big draw and everything. So they are going to let him, you know, go a little longer.
Of course not. The thing was... Keep talking, brother.
You know...
Keep talking.
Yeah, so... you know, sometimes I get in my head, I think about it, but I'm not trying to do that too much. But I think it is what it is. At the same time, he fought like a champion. You know, he didn't want to quit. And it is what it is. Yep. You know, I just gotta keep going and keep getting better. So next time I get a shot, I'll be ready and I'll be better than what I was then.
And you're getting better and you're getting better. I just know that was his first fight under the top ranked banner with Bob Arum. That was his first fight under the top ranked banner. So there was no way that Bob Arum was just got this guy. I just got this guy.
Right.
And now this happened. No, like, he must fucking, we got, listen, I don't care if his head fall off. Don't stop fighting. You understand what I'm saying? That's the end. I know how the business of boxing works. What do you think? What's next for you? What do you want next?
We haven't been able to discuss much, but I'm meeting with my team this week to see what's next. But I hope to fight maybe June, July. And I got to deal with Showtime. So I'm fighting on Showtime. And
congrats, man.
Thank you. Thanks.
It's awesome.
Yeah, it's very good. It's very good. So I had two fights with them now. And I got that offer from them after the Fury fight. So that's good, of course. And June, July. And I just fought Dominic Brazil. So I'm thinking somebody.
That was a great fight.
He's a pretty good name. So, you know, the natural thing is to move on from there and somebody a little higher up.
Yes, sir. Well, I'm going to let you know we got a lot of good fighters. The heavyweight division is where you at. You got Joe Joyce. You got Otto Wallin. You got Christopher Lovejoy. You got Michael Coffey. You understand what I'm saying? You got the young boy. You got the young boys coming out of here. I just saw one of them fight last night. I forget his name. But, yeah, man, right now the heavyweight division is as hot as it's been in years.
Yeah.
Like back in the 90s. The heavyweight division is popping like it was popping in the 90s. You understand what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And you at the top of the heat, Otto Wallin. You at the top of the heat. I like your fighting style. I love your fighting style. You're an intelligent boxer. Everything off your jab. You cross your T's and dot your I's. You make sure you got your hand up. Your defense is on tack. You throw your punches nice and clean. I really like that. I really like that part about you stylistically.
Thank you. What? Yeah, I think that's probably be my style my whole career. But of course, I've been getting better. I've been having great team with me. And I think that's very important. I have my trainer, Joey, that I met in 2013 over in Europe, actually. We were training out there. So we were there for 4 or 5 years. And then Joey decided to move back here to New York. And then I followed him here. And then he's helped me over here, you know, with everything. And it's been just a blessing to work with Joey. He's really taken my career where I wanted it to go. And, you know, I owe him very much.
And yes, Raymond, Joey Kamachi was a beast himself. He was a two-time world champion. You understand what I'm saying? And it's not often that fighters can go and transfer over to the trainer and be good. You understand what I'm saying? He's the one able to do that. You know what I'm saying? He's a boxing purist. You know what I'm saying? And he has no ego. He loves teaching. I'm a big fan of Joey Kamachi as well. Huge fan of Joey Kamachi.
Yeah, no, I think you're right about that. Not every great fighter is going to be a great trainer. But I think Joey, he's a very humble guy. And he told me after he finished his career, he went on to become a trainer. And he felt like he had to learn everything all over again. So after a while, he got to work with Emmanuel Stewart. And he went in there and, you know, he said he was looking for something special. But then after a while, he just realized it's not going to be anything special. It's just the basics, you know, normal stuff. And you do it over and over again, and you just keep getting better. And that's what, I think that was Emmanuel's formula. I never met him, but they say he was a very simple, you know, good jab, good defense, good footwork.
Yes, sir.
You know, and I think that's what Joey's doing. And he, like I said, when he became a trainer, he had to really learn it all over again. And I think that's what you got to do if you got to become a trainer. Because because you've been a good fighter doesn't mean you'll be a good trainer.
You have to learn how to teach.
Yeah.
You got to learn how to teach.
Yeah.
And that's actually where I met Joliet at Crunk Boxing Gym, because during that time, I was at Crunk Boxing Gym.
Wow.
So I met Joey there. I was training with Javen Hill and Emmanuel, obviously. Yeah. And that's where I met Joey, and, you know, going to camps and shit like that. That's where I met Joey at.
Nice.
And Joey Gamach, and Joey Gamach has just been a great guy and a great trainer. I got nothing bad to say about him. I love him.
Thank you. Yeah, me too. How was it out there, to train out there at the Crunk?
Wow. Training out, like, it's a real small, it's so small. The Crunk gym is so small. You go in there, you got one ring. You got, like, two heavy bags. You got one ring, you got two heavy bags. And you got, like, a little couple weights thrown around on the floor. You know what I'm saying? It's just small. It's a real small gym. You go downstairs, it's hot as fuck down there. But when you go downstairs, it's some work getting put in down there, boy.
Yeah.
Everybody in there serious, and everybody, don't get me wrong, we joke and have fun like everybody else, but everybody in there putting in work. You see some crazy sparring down there.
Yeah.
I can give you some. The USA boxing team, sometime they would come down, they would train that Crunk. Obviously, you had the professional fighters coming down training that Crunk. It was just different. It was just different, and I was able to put in a lot of pain in that boxing gym.
Nice,
you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, I mean,
any gym I go to, I put in pain. That's what I do, baby. I'm a pain putter. But
do you think it's?
I got fucked up too. I got fucked up too a few times.
You think it still looks the same as it did then today? It's the same feel, same looking feel.
It's done now. It's done now. The Crunk Boxing Gym is done now.
Really?
And you know what? Oh, you know what? It's so crazy we're talking. It's so crazy we're having this conversation, right? Because now, Tyson Fury is with Javen Hill.
True.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's
so
a good point.
So Tyson Fury, that's Crunk right there.
Yep.
And, like, you see how this shit is full circle? Like, your trainer's a Crunk fighter. I'm a Crunk fighter. Tyson Fury, like, you see how this shit is coming? It's crazy.
Yeah. Boxing is a pretty small world, you know?
Very small world. Very small world. Wow. Yeah. I'm that shit just kind of hitting me like, oh, shit. Javen, because I was talking about Javen training me, but Javen trained Fury.
Yeah.
and Javen trained Vladimir Klitschko.
Yeah.
Vladimir Klitschko's a Crunk fighter. You understand what I'm saying? So you see how this whole shit goes full circle, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, man. Otto, you brought up the, you know, stuff you've been working on with Joey, like, since you've been with him. And one of the things you mentioned was footwork, and I think Eric and I even said it, when you fought Brazil, we could see that footwork was phenomenal. The head movement, your defense just in general, was sort of a display of your defense, because, you know, you were moving, and then you were, you know, you even on the ropes. Is that something that you specifically have been working on? Like, what other things have you been, you know, really, really trying to harness or you know, strengthen in the last year, 2 years?
I would say that we've always been working on our defense. Every day we work defense. And I think it's very important, especially being a heavyweight. You don't want to take those punches. So
true.
We're always working that defense, you know, footwork, upper body movement, being able to pick the shots and block them. That's very important. So we're always working on that. There's a bunch of other stuff we're working, of course. But I feel like Joey is a trainer also, that he teaches me to be all around and to be able to do everything. So then once we get an opponent, we look at him and say, oh, okay, you know, be on the lookout for this, you know, be ready for this, and you got to throw this and be sure you do this. So I feel like, you know, it's all starting to come together for me now. I'm 30 now, but I feel younger, you know, I haven't taken any punishment in my career, and I feel like I'm improving, and being here in New York has been great for me. It's been great being here in New York.
Awesome.
Yeah, especially, you know, being in a community where there's a lot of boxing, and you know, you can go watch the fights and also, you know, to have different sparring all the time, good heavyweight sparring on a regular basis. That's really important. And that was always something that was hard for me when I was living at home in Sweden and Denmark before, to, you know, to get a lot of heavyweights.
Getting the sparring.
Yeah. So that's been huge here.
Yes, sir.
Very good.
You know what? You've been doing your thing. I can't really say you're a prospect. You're not a prospect. You fought for the title against Fury. You came back. You had a couple good wins since then. You're right there.
Yeah.
At SouthBoX Radio, we don't beat around the bush. We get to the fucking point. Who you want? We got a lot of them out there. Who you want?
You know what? I mean, I would like somebody, like I said, a little better than Brazil. If I could get maybe Charles Martin, that would be nice. Guy like him.
That'd be a good fight. That'd be a real good fight.
That'd be a great
Charles
fight.
Charles Martin would be a good fight.
Yeah, I think he's got good ranking, everything, and we're both southpaws actually, and I think that could be a good fight. And he fights for PBC, I think, and Showtime and PBC got a good connection.
Okay,
yeah. I like that.
So that's actually doable.
Hopefully, I mean, he might. I think he's been linked to Wilder, but I'm not sure what's going on there.
Yeah, nobody really knows what's going on with Wilder.
Sorry,
We don't know. We just got to wait to see what Wilder. Yeah. I like, you know what I was thinking, but this is the boxing fan in me. This is the fan in me.
Yeah.
I would like to see Otto Wallin, Luis Ortiz. I would love to see that fight. I think Otto Wallin got Ortiz. I'm sorry. I think Otto Wallin got Ortiz.
Yeah,
I would like to see Ortiz. I think Ortiz is a fucking killer too. I'm not gonna lie to you. You feel me? I think Otto Wallin. I just think.
And Ortiz is a PBC guy too, right?
Yeah, he is.
Yeah.
And Reese, seems like nobody wants to fight him, right? But you gotta look at him and see he's been very good. But he's getting older too. I mean, he's pushing 40 something. And
do you say Otto Ruiz?
Fucking Wallin Ortiz.
Ortiz.
Yeah.
Wallin Ortiz.
Yeah, that could be the fight.
That would be a great fight.
Yeah.
That's the fucking fight. And guess what? That's the fight. It's a winnable fight.
Yeah.
It's a good matchup. Yeah.
Fight, though. It ain't an easy fight at all. Don't sleep on the old man. The old man can hit, and the old man got some skills. The old man will fuck a motherfucker up. Don't sleep on the mic because they can disrespect Luis Ortiz. Yeah. Southpaw too? Come on, son.
Yeah. But the footwork is the best thing you could implement against a guy like that.
I'm just saying, Otto Wallin, like I said, Otto Wallin have been in there with Fury. He done fought for the title, and the Fury fight was a couple years ago. He done fought for the title. He done fought a couple guys after that. Let this mother, like, that's the level he's on.
Yeah.
You fight a champion or you fight a former champion or somebody that fought for the championship. You understand what I'm saying?
Yep.
That's the level that Otto Wallin is on. So I'm not mad at the Charles Martin fight. I'm not mad at that. Charles Martin was a champ for two rounds, but he was a champ. You feel me?
Yeah.
You feel what I'm saying? Yeah, so that's a good name. Or fucking tease. And guess what? Otto Wallin win that fight. Watch what the stock do. But he got to go to a training camp. He got to, like I said, don't sleep with that motherfucker. That motherfucker dangerous.
Yeah.
Luis is dangerous.
Yeah, he's
really King Kong. He really King Kong.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? But, hey, I'm just a fan talking. You feel me? I'm just a fan, so fuck it. You know, what I say don't mean nothing. You understand what I'm saying?
But No, but this is what a lot of people think and certainly feel like, you know, from what we've seen from you, Otto, like you're getting better every fight, man, and it's awesome to see. It's awesome to watch. Everybody's eyes are glued when they see that your name's on the card.
Otto Wallin got speed, Otto Wallin got power. He know how to get on his toes, you know what I'm saying? The motherfucker can fight. He wouldn't have beat me, but he can fight.
I would never go in there with you.
You're a little bit small for the heavyweight division, E.
I'm a middleweight.
You're a little small. Yeah,
fuck me up. Otto beat the shit out of me, man. Yo, Otto, how you ain't been in SouthBoX yet? I got the number one boxing gym in the world.
Yeah. Yeah, we're coming up there.
No. Have you seen it, Otto?
What?
You've seen SouthBoX, right?
Yeah. Yeah.
How long
guess
did you
who
say?
Own it? Guess who owned it? Guess who owned it?
Is it that guy? What's his name? That crazy guy?
You know the owner.
That's accurate. That's accurate. That's accurate.
You know the owner, man. Let's go pull up the SouthBoX gym. I'd love to have you, man.
Yeah. That's a great thing with the gym.
Yeah, thank you.
It's
so
always,
much.
You know, boxing needs to stay alive, and you need gyms like that.
Yeah, and guess what? You ain't seen nothing yet because I'm about to do some more. It's not just going to be that gym. No, it's not just going to be that right now. That's what we got now. You understand what I'm saying? We about to go here. You understand what I'm saying? It's not gonna just stop, like, no.
Nice. How do you get that name, SouthBoX?
South Bronx.
Oh, okay.
SouthBoX by Eric Kelly.
Nice.
Where in the five boroughs are you, Otto? Are you in Manhattan?
Yeah, in Chelsea.
Okay. Oh, nice, man. It's a great area. Anywhere downtown is awesome. The Village.
Yeah.
Chelsea, you know.
Yeah.
Tribeca. It's a beautiful area.
Yeah. I live right by MSG, so it's nice.
Okay.
Yeah.
I used to live on 27th Street and 6th Ave. 7776.
Oh, nice.
Ave.
Yeah, I'm 31st and 6th Ave.
Oh, you was there first. Yeah.
I'm 31st. 31st.
31st and 6th. Yeah. So you're right there. I had so much fun when, like, Thursday, Friday, Saturday night, that neighborhood. Oh my goodness! But when you're a fighter, when you're Otto Wallin, you gotta stay away from that shit.
Yeah.
When you Eric Kelly, that's heaven.
No, it's a nice area.
Hey, can I ask another question, guys? Otto, you know, being from Sweden, like, I'm a history buff a little bit, and I know from, you know, studying up my boxing history, like, there are some historic champs like Ingemar Johansson, right? In terms of your, like, legacy, like, what are you hoping to achieve, you know, when said and done with your career, like, what types of things, and also just on, like, the next, you know, from now until the end of your career, for, like, growing your brand, I know Sweden's a small country. Is boxing big enough in Sweden that you can continue to still grow your brand there, or you have to do it, like, in the U.S. and, you know, internationally?
Yeah, I mean, my goal has always been to be world champion. And, you know, I fought for the title with Fury. I came pretty close, you know, coming out of nowhere. And so I know that I just got to keep working now, keep fighting, keep getting the experience so I would get better. And then when I get another shot, I'll be ready to win it. So that's goal. That's my goal, of course. And
I got a question, Otto Wallin. What was your amateur background like? I'm not, but because by you being from Sweden, you know what I'm saying? What was your amateur background like?
I had about 40, 45 amateur fights.
Okay.
I turned pro pretty early, at 22. I I had the chance to turn pro, and I felt like that was gonna give me the best training, so I could get as good as I could get and fulfill my potential. You know, I didn't have to work. I could, you know, only box and train, and I would go abroad and have full-time trainers and everything. So that's what I decided to do, and I made my way to the first spot in Sweden before, and so I fought abroad on the national team and stuff like that. And we went over to Eastern Europe a lot and different tournaments. And then I was qualified for the Olympics in 2012. I tried to, but I lost first round. And after that, I turned pro.
Okay.
Boxing.
So you tried for the Olympics. And that would have been the 2012 Olympics?
Or yes, yeah.
2012 Olympics?
Yeah. I mean, my goal was really the 2016. But then,
your goal was for the 2016 game.
Yeah, that was my real goal. And then I felt like, you know, boxing wasn't big in Sweden. So I felt like I'm going to try to go there, you know, maybe catch a medal and then, you know, get a good contract and turn pro. Right. But it all happened earlier for me. Like I said, after I lost that time in 2012, I felt like I have a good offer on the table to turn pro already. Yeah. And I think that's going to make me better.
Yeah,
absolutely.
Because you touched it, and boxing isn't huge in Sweden. It's not very big. And professional boxing was banned for about 40 years.
I didn't know that.
Yeah, they hurt boxing a lot. So I think now, I mean, it's allowed now. So it's getting better, and I feel like it's picking up. But we really need somebody. I think we need somebody to stand out and, you know, be a good fighter and to bring, you know, the people together, and then boxing is going to blossom, I feel like.
Yes, sir.
I think we know the guy that's going to do it.
I hope it to be me. At least one of them.
I think so.
Yeah, I'm a big fan of yours. I think it can be you. I think, like I said, I think you're right up there with the top of the best at heavyweight. And a belt will be around your waist. A world title will be around your waist. That's a fact. And fucking with Al Heyman, PBC, you got the right team behind you. A belt will be around your waist.
Yeah, that's my dream.
You know what I'm saying?
I guess I'm working. I'm working every day to fulfill that dream.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. And you got my support, man. I'm a big fan of yours. I'm glad you came here on SouthBoX Radio and blessed me with your presence. Like,
of course.
Like right now, like we new to this. You helping my brand. You helping our brand right now. Me and Max.
That's right.
So right now, you bless me with your presence and everything. When I put this up, like, oh shit, Otto Wallin, what's up? and to be honest, I don't understand why all the fucking the blogs and the web, like, this who they need to talk to. How you not talking to him?
Yeah.
Do you see what he did? Do you see who he's been in the ring with? And when he in the ring with these guys, what he do? This is one of the top heavyweights in the world.
Yeah.
He only got one loss, and that loss could have easily been a win. And it was against a great heavyweight champion.
Yeah.
Otto Wallin is who the fuck you supposed to be talking to. Put your attention on Otto Wallin. That's how I go, man.
Yeah.
Yo, thank you so much for doing this with me, man. I appreciate you so much, Otto.
Of course, yeah. I appreciate you guys, and it's good. We all help each other, you know.
Yes, yes.
Get absolutely. The word out.
Yeah. All right, thanks for having me, guys.
Thank you so much, Otto.
My brother.
Thank
you. See you later.
Talk to you soon. Have a good day, man.
Yeah,
enjoy your Sunday.
If you don't come to my gym, I'm going to fuck you up.
Let's go, champ.